Suresh, can I continue? All are joined.
Yes, sir.
Joined, sir.
Joined?
Yes, sir.
Please continue. Can I continue? Okay. So, listen attentively. Okay. Men, honestly, knew very well that many times we never attend our women properly. Okay. That is the difference between listening and active listening. Active listening. Even the eye contact, the body language, and all the other aspects matters in the listen attentively and be forgiving. Be forgiving. Actually, many a times from the brain differences, you understood that men, they will not react immediately, but they will be storing all those things. One day they will blast. So, we should be developing the habit of forgiving the others. Forgiveness is the biggest boom, if at all you have it, not only in your relationship, even with any relationship in the external world. That's what Buddha beautifully said. You will not be punished for your anger. You will be punished by your own anger. And if at all you look at the record on cardiac surgeries and cardiac arrest, okay, men are more prone to have the cardiac arrest than the women. The simplest reason is women, they express their emotion immediately, whereas men, they hold their emotion and later that may be turned into the psychosomatic illness and finally they have the physical problems like the cardiac arrest. So we should learn, the men, we should learn the habit of forgiving. But it doesn't mean that only men should have, even women, you should equally have this habit, because women are highly capable of recalling after 15 years of marriage. You know, immediately after the marriage, your mother, she has commented me like this, you didn't attend, you didn't take care of me. And they will create the problem after 15 years. And do remember, you can cry for whatever happened immediately. Okay? If at all you have lost your grandfather, immediately you can cry. But if you are crying that I have lost the grandfather 40 years before, I have lost my grandfather 40 years before, what is your age? 28. What is your age? 28. That should not be the case. You should not cry for even again and again. Again and again. That's what Charlie Chaplin beautifully said. You cannot laugh for the same event again and again. You will get monotony. You will get bored. You will get irritated. Similarly, you should not repeat the same behavior, recalling the past and irritating the male member. So forgiveness is common. That's why it was mentioned as expressing how we have to express the love to the partner. So it may be male or female. Then smile lovingly. Today with the great competition in the society, many people, I hope, we forget to smile. That's the biggest problem. That's the biggest problem. So first we have to take these kind of people for treatment. That's what my feeling. See, as I said, there is a fun in everything. What we do, what we see, what we observe, what's happening around. Likewise, we should smile lovingly. Okay, on seeing your face, the other partner should not be irritated. That's very important. Then we must show the gratitude. Gratitude. Gratitude is one of the finest quality. Thereby, we can express our heartfelt thankfulness to the other person. So we must show our gratitude. Then compliment your, next slide. Compliment your partner in the company of others, in the presence of others, like in the gathering or in the family function or in the other functions. Okay, you can express that how they are important to you. Okay, what kind of value they have added to your life. That's very, very important. Right? Then hold the hands. Actually, research studies shows that holding the hands of the partner, that itself is the satisfying factor for the other life partner. And not only that, it paves the path for the intimate relationship. Then dance intimately. Okay? Dance intimately. Immediately don't go to the Western culture. Even within the family, you can in the closed rooms, you can dance. You can sing a song and dance. But remember, if your voice is not good, don't torture the partner by singing the song. That's also there. Nowadays, we have the video player and audio player in our mobile phone itself. So, within your closed walls, you can sing, dance. That's also, will dance together. That's very important. Not dancing alone. So, that will also enrich your relationship. Then, be forgiving. Dance intimately. Then tickle and wrestle each other. Okay? The tickling and wrestling, etc. That immediately will lead to the intimate relationship. then you can express your love in a variety of ways. Say how to say I love you in a variety of ways. There is a separate website which will teach you how you can convey I love you in a number of ways. For example, okay, you can express your love. You complete me. You can fill in the blanks. You are precious. You can fill in the blanks. And you are my life. You are my life. Likewise, you can express your love in the possible variety of ways. Okay, then, what are the keys to successful romantic relationship? The key to success, next slide, key for successful romantic relationship. The first one is, express your love to the partner. Express your love to the partner, just as you have completed that area. Then, show some affection. Okay, whatever you do, whatever you say, you must express your affection. Affection, either by touching or gazing or even through the eyes, you can express the affection. Actually, even the touching the shoulder is the good quality which express, don't touch the neighbor woman, etc. and don't get into the problem. Touching your spouse's shoulder, okay, which is a good way of expressing the affection. Then show appreciation for your partner. Already we have mentioned how you can express the love to your partner by complimenting your partner in the company of others. The same thing valid here. Share yourself. Share yourself. You can talk to your problems, you can talk to your development, etc. And do remember that the other person is also having a brain, other person is also capable of. Don't expect that your partner is the idiot. And be there for your partner. Whenever there is a problem, whenever there is a need, whenever there is a crisis, you should ensure that I am here for you. I am here for you. Then you can surprise your partner with the gifts. Not only the gold ornament or some silk sarees, even the small gifts. For example, nowadays many of the small gifts are available in the market. And do remember, women, they enjoy these kind of small gifts. So you can surprise your partner with a different kind of small gifts. Then respond gracefully to your partner's demands and shortcomings. Okay, this is the most important area. This is what I used to colloquially say, that the successful marriage is nothing but identifying the right idiot to accept your idiocy. The successful marriage is nothing but identifying the right idiot to accept your idiocy. So that's what it is. Respond gracefully to your partner's demands and shortcomings. Remember, no one is perfect. And make alone time a priority. Okay, make alone means you are not alone. Both of you are alone. That's very important. Okay, nowadays from the counseling part, I have witnessed that both the partner, they want to be alone separately, not together. That's what I am surprising nowadays. And take nothing for granted. As I said already, the partner is also the human being. So never take anything for granted. And most of the time, the men, we are committing this mistake. We are taking our women for granted and we are hurting them. We are hurting them in many ways without unknowingly or knowingly. Then strive for equality. Whatever you do, whatever you make the decision, you should ensure the equality. Then make a dedicated time for those who matter. Make a dedicated time for those who matter. Then attack the problem, not the person. Whenever there are certain issues, normally being the psychologist, most of you know that the discussion is always better than argument. Because in the argument, you are trying to prove who is right, but in the discussion, we are trying to identify what is right. So we have to identify. Attack the problem, not the person. Be the most positive person you know. You should be a role model, like the extreme positive person, what you know. Then never jump into conclusions. Don't under-promise and over-deliver. That's the biggest issue with the male member. Don't under-promise, and the female member, don't over-deliver. Communicate candidly and honestly. Communicate with the other person very, very candidly and honestly. Actually, there was an experiment done by Alvin, he was popular in stress management exercises, and he was a researcher, good researcher in stress and coping. And the experiment itself is called as Alvin's experiment. Okay, so after making a number of trials and attempts, one day he was addressing the gathering in his home that, see, if you experience the stress, it's very, very easy. You just sit and think. The Alvin's wife was just staring on him. Alvin got doubt. After the people left the home, he asked, what happened? Why are you staring on me while I'm explaining that? Sit and think. You never done it in the life, dear. Okay, coming back to the point. So never jump into conclusions and don't under-promise and over-deliver. Then communicate candidly and honestly. Be passionately appreciative. Then connect through service. Connect through service. And do remember, in the communication, we used to say that report communication and rapport communication. And we must understand the human brain wiring, especially from the male brain and the female brain. We understood the functions of the female brain, the capacity of the female brain, as well as the male brain. In the lighter sense, I used to tell the 21 minutes principle whenever and wherever I go for the program. What is the 21 minutes principle? Once if the male member returns from the office, right, just don't talk to him for 21 minutes. And you know very well that our male member, normally they don't have the patience to watch even the advertisement in the TV. What they normally will do is they will take the remote control and they will keep on changing the channels. Nobody can watch all those channels. That's the reality. It's a kind of ventilating the stress. After 21 minutes, automatically they will come to the normalcy and they will easily approachable and communicable. But when the female member, if she returns from the office, I used to tell the male members, immediately talk to her whether your journey is safe, you are comfortable, how was the day? She will be very, very happy. She will be very, very happy. The simple reason is, if you take the communication, for men, communication is the report communication, sending the message. But for women, it's sharing of love and affection. Even I could quote an example. If the male member is working and he is going to the coffee shop with the friend, normally he is going to the coffee shop to the friend, and none of the male member normally will come back to the home and explain, I went to this coffee shop. Normally our member, even they go to the task map, they will not inform, only you have to identify. But they will not inform you where they have gone, who came, who they met, etc. But if the woman is working and she had a friend, they went to the coffee shop, and after returning to the home, you know how they will express all these things. See, today I went to Saravana Bhavan. See, none of the server is neat and clean. Even that fellow's finger was touching the tip of the tumbler. I have shouted with him. Even the coffee is not tasty as I am making. Likewise, they will keep on telling so many things. It's not that they have the complaint or they want to narrate about the Saravana Bhavan. Rather, with the communication, they are very happy. For men, it is report communication. For women, it is rapport communication. Hence, we should think of the mistakes to be avoided in the couple relationship. Number one, avoid picking on partner's fault. Okay? Avoid picking on partner's fault. And do remember, we are living in the world where people are always ready to identify and exaggerate your mistakes only. So, avoid picking on partner's fault. Number two, avoid complacency. Actually, complaining type. Complacency is nothing but making complaints. So, avoid complacency. Avoid seeking instant gratification in the human relationship, especially the close relationship. We cannot seek the instant gratification. Okay, in the coffee, you may have the instant coffee. In the dosa, you may look for the instant dosa mix. But in the relationship, nothing is instant. Okay, it should be cherished. It should be understood. It should be appreciated. Only then you will feel the aroma and taste. Feel the aroma and taste. Even there is a small quote about this aroma and taste. Somebody has quoted beautifully. Each and every woman, they have their separate aroma. They have a smell. They have their separate flavor. They have their etc. etc. But the problem with the men is they are always looking for the fruit salad. And avoid carrying your old baggage. Avoid carrying your old baggage. Already I have mentioned about this. Avoid having unrealistic expectation. And do remember, we can perform only up to our potential. So avoid unrealistic expectation from the life partner. Avoid forcing your partner to change. Already in the previous session also I have mentioned this. See, change should be from within. So, if at all you are expecting any change from your partner, first you must change. Only then the other people will change, especially the partner will change. Avoid arguing to win. With the arguments, nothing will happen. Already we have seen this. Then avoid creating negative anchors. Avoid creating negative anchors in your life. Next slide. Next slide, please. Somehow you are both the best and the worst thing that had happened to me. Okay? That's what the mentality of many of the men and women together, men and women today. So let us hope for the best relationship. Okay, thank you. Thank you for your passion. Listen.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Oh.
Yes, thank you.
Yes. Yes, we had a session on forensic science recently. Your performance like the forensic report of marital life. What, why, how all the questions have been answered. And
I'm
really surprised that the audience have not posted a single question because you have answered from
many of the questions.
Yeah,
A to Z. Veena, just a minute. There are two ways, okay? One is they have understood everything, right? And the second aspect is you know the answer. Okay, it's not like that. Many people have the inhibition to talk about these kind of things by posing a question. That's the real issue. If it comes to the individual session, I have seen many of the women, they raise so many questions. But in the open forum, normal, still we have the inhibition to raise the question. That might.
But still, I think someone has posted a question, sir, like to elaborate on the attachment stuff.
Okay. Yes. Elaborate on that.
Please explain more about attachment from Vijay Kumar Jagannathan.
Vijay Kumar Jagannathan. See, actually, we use wide variety of attachment. Okay. See, in the Buddhist philosophy, we used to say that the attachment should be the detached. Like we got married, there is no other way, so we have to be attached. That is also a kind of attachment. Then the other one is emotional attachment. We can have the emotional attachment. And sometimes we have the mixture of these two. In many cases, the Lucifer style of attachment is highly effective. Somebody has other question. I have noticed the question. Somebody raised the question. Even my the wife expects the love, care, etc., etc. Do remember, she should expect only from you. Don't forget that. Even that's what I have quoted. In the COVID-19 cases, one lady at the age of 96 or something else, she has mentioned about the love and affection with the husband, and she was expecting that the husband should be recovered. The 100 and something year husband has been recovered. Right. So, what may be your age? Definitely, they will be expecting from you only. Don't worry. And of course, it's your bound duty. Not the middle age, not the old age. Till you are alive, you have to support your spouse. There is no other option, and it should be. That's your moral responsibility. Yes.
We have a question from Govindan Marimuthu, sir.
Don't mention the name. Better don't mention the name.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Just to say the question, I'll give the answer.
No, sir. He has raised his hand so that he has
okay, to ask fine. The question. Okay. Yes, please.
Yes, Govindan, sir. Please go ahead with your question.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Please. Govindan, sir. Solange.
Thank you for the presentation.
Thank you, professor.
Hello.
Yes, professor.
Just now you told that. Is it correct today?
No, your voice is not clear. Suddenly it is broken.
Unconditional acceptance. Is it correct? Hello?
Yeah, unconditional acceptance. The meaning of the love is unconditional acceptance.
Is it acceptable? Is it practicable?
Which one? Unconditional acceptance.
Hello.
Oh, sir, I couldn't get your question. Oh, sir.
Today.
Sir. Today. Yes, please.
Unconditional acceptance. You told that.
Yeah.
Love is unconditional acceptance. Am I right?
Yeah. That is the meaning. That is the. That is it possible today means if you really care for the other person, definitely it's possible. We are talking about the spouse especially. Okay? Right. You should make it possible. That's what my request. Right. If in the general sense, the meaning of love has been turned into lust. I'm not coming for that area. But with the spouse, it should be. It should be.
Thank you, sir.
We have another question from Payal. Payal, can you
please
go ahead?
Hello, sir.
Yes.
This question belongs to my friend actually. She asked me, actually, she pretend that she is doing everything in her house, but her husband doesn't give the title to her, or you say her husband want his expectation is too much actually, according to her.
Yeah.
Right. But if I heard about from her husband, he used to say that if she is doing one thing, she used to elaborate it in let's say 10 points, right?
So yeah, that's the basic nature of situation? No, that is the basic nature of woman. Because see, make your son-in-law to understand that she is longing for your love and affection. That's why she is elaborating the communication. That's the real reason. Okay, it's quite normal. It's a normal behavior only. But men, they didn't have the patience to listen all these things, listen the stories. That's why he might say that no, she's doing one thing and elaborating that she has done 10 things. But it's not the case. Actually, probably they may not have the proper communication between them. That's why she wants to attract him through this kind of communication. Okay? Tell your son-in-law to focus on your daughter.
When this lockdown situation, when everything they have to do their own, so now the problem is very difficult for them to live together.
Yeah. Definitely, because in our Indian society, most of the male member, they have trained to, they have the inherited trait that how to dominate the woman. Do you accept it? Yeah. You have seen with your parents also. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So now, when actually, even if you ask me, when I'm going to office, it's easy for me. At 8:30, everything will be ready on my table. Right. I will take the food and I will run away. It's very, very comfortable for me. Now, even we are unable to get the servant maid, so wife alone is struggling to do the household activity. So we have to sacrifice certain thing, and the sacrificed tendency will be possible if you have the real care and love for your wife. Because ultimately, at the end of the day, if she is suffering, they are hypervigilant, and even for the small things they will go to the doctor. But you know the attitude of women, they will not reveal the problem. They have the tolerance for those kind of problems. If the kid or husband have the problem, they will become hypervigilant. Immediately they will take the kids or the husband to the hospital. But women, they will not reveal. So by internalizing all those things, they will be suffering a lot. That's the reality. Right? That's what I insist the male members. Kindly attend the body language and the body problems of your own woman. That's very, very important. So tell him to attend all those things.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. We have a question from Soundarya.
Please. Yes, Soundarya, please. Unmute your radio.
Yeah, I have two questions, sir.
I'm very poor in my memory, so ask one by one.
Yes, sir. So the first question is...
Yeah, first question.
Unconditional, right? Unconditional.
Yeah.
So, but at one point, when we continue to give unconditional acceptance, sometimes doesn't give the other person the opportunity to take advantage of us, because they know no matter what they do, she is going to accept you. And what if they start taking advantage?
Wait. I'll answer this with a small story, then you can decide. Actually, there was a priest, okay? He used to go for the weekend preaching, and in a meeting he was explaining about Jesus Christ told that if the person slaps you in one side, you have to show the second side. Okay, the priest is a gigantic fellow. On hearing this, one fellow came and slapped him on one side. The priest has shown the second side. Then he has slapped the priest on the second side of the second side also. You know what happened? The priest is a gigantic fellow. He took that fellow and he smashed him like this. He kicked the fellow like this. And this fellow was shouting. See, only you said that Jesus has taught like this. But why you are doing like this? The priest politely said, Jesus never instructed me what to do if the person again slapped you on the second side. Okay? It is purely up to you to make the decision.
Okay?
It is purely up to you to make the decision. What's the second question?
The second question is, sir, sometimes in relationship when one person, you have listed on a lot of tips and tactics to keep the intimacy or keep the relationship good, right? So what if one person continues to keep trying and in spite of them openly expressing how the situation is or what is expected or how much...
See, mostly that one person should be from the women's side, am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that is the basic problem. That's what I have insisted in several places. I have mentioned about the men. So sit and discuss with him openly. That's the only solution.
That's what, sir. Even right. After discussing, if the person doesn't do anything to change, and is there anything else can the woman do?
See, the men brain wiring is very, very linear. Okay, linear and sequential. They will not do it immediately. Not I'm supporting men. So you have to repeatedly tell him. You have to repeatedly tell him. You have to express your displeasure. Okay? And you know the defense mechanism. How certain things can be withheld. So you can use the defense mechanism. Right? Accordingly, you have to try to correct the man.
Okay.
That's the only way. Nothing seems to work means you can take your own decision. You have the right, fundamental right, your own decision. Respect is mutual, not one-sided.
Yes,
thank you, sir. We have a question in chat.
Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah, please. Thank you, ma'am.
Husband,
yeah, Vina.
Yes, sir. Husband is hiring financial things like loan, debt, lending money to help others from wife. Though wife conveys him, her only expectation is to share those financial things. How to handle this?
See, when I make my presentation, I mentioned after a particular period, especially this is called as midlife crisis. This is called as midlife crisis. After a particular, so you have to revisit your love and affection. That's the better thing. Even once in a year, actually, I have prepared so many points. I am unable to cover it. That's why I stopped. There are about 50 different tips. Okay, I'll do one thing. I'll provide the PDF version. No, not PPT. I'll provide the PDF version by posting this PPT in the group. You can post the PDF also. Right? Because I cannot put all those things in there. PowerPoint, and I know the time limit too. So you can make him to take definitely to take a break and go for a surprise trips or summer vacation trips, or if the summer vacation is not there, you can plan whenever it's convenient for you, you can plan a trip. So remember that you must spend at least 5 to 7 days as the personal time in a year. Okay, so make him to follow the simple rule. There is a personal time. Apart from all those things, we must share the personal time. The basic problem with the men is they are taking everything for granted once if they are getting married and settled in the family life. Okay? Even I should also admit that. Right? That should not be the case.
Thank you.
Next.
Another question from Arvind Kumar. In Indian context, female members sacrifice and compromise more male members in establishing the relationship.
Yeah, 1000% true. 1000% true.
Thank you.
Not even 100%.
Yes, thank you, Aravind, for that. And we have one from Dr. Chidambaranathan. If I recall the matters which has happened before 14 years, issues with mother-in-law, how can I respond?
That's what I said. Don't dwell into your past. Okay, what is the use of it? You can write your own journal. Take the diary and write. What are all the things happened? What's the outcome? What's the learning from that? Okay, how you can be a better person despite of all those nonsense. Okay, if you focus on the solution, you will get the solution. But if you are recalling all those things, those are the problem. If you focus on the problem, the problems will be multiplied. So choice is yours.
Yes, we have the counter from Ranjit Kumar on, like, I have seen many men doing much of compromise to have the relationship life. So it's a win-win situation between Arvind and Ranjit Kumar.
So they have their own answers.
Better to their own imagination, sir.
Yeah. Because we can't answer all the imagination.
Yeah, men can be creative in this aspect, I guess.
Yes, yes. See, remember, there is no win or loss in the relationship. If you think about it, there is no question will be like this. Okay? What kind of satisfaction you have, what amount of sharing you have, that's the most important thing.
Next, we have a question from Vishnu. If a woman has a tendency to react like men, how to handle
this? See, actually, in the sexual counseling, we used to say, who is playing the cock role and who is playing the hen role? And the opposite person should play the opposite role automatically.
Yes. Okay, sir. We have.
Okay, so the things cannot be explained openly in the open forum, dear.
Yes. Sir, we have a question from Rama, ma'am. Ma'am, please go ahead with
you. Hello, sir. Good evening, sir.
Hello, ma'am. How are you?
I'm fine, sir. One question.
Yeah, please, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Why don't
you... You have also had a question, ma'am.
No.
Yeah, please.
I like your humorous answers. So, this is not for an answer. It is for your answer.
Please.
Particularly.
Yeah.
Why don't men listen? Now, you give your answer.
Yeah?
Why don't men listen?
So that is the problem with the men. They don't listen. That's why you have to repeatedly tell him thrice or four times. Only then they will listen. Their program is linear programming. Okay. Once if they miss the information, they will forget the information. So again and again, you have to program them.
Sir, by doing
you know what you are doing with your husband.
By doing two, three times, we are going mad. So what to do?
Sorry, I won't accept this point, ma'am. See, if you really have the care that your men should listen to you, you will try to find out your own way. Right?
Yes.
So don't say that I will become mad. Rather, that's what I'm keep on telling people. Not only here, even when I'm going for counseling and therapy, I used to tell the people. Okay? See, whatever happens is your lesson. Okay? Now try to learn a better lesson. Right? That would be the right attitude.
Good, sir.
That would throw the foundation for the long-lasting relationship.
Yes, thank you, sir. We have.
Thank you, thank you, sir.
Thank you, Rama, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Kartikeyan, sir, with his question. Yes, unmute yourself, Kartikeyan, sir.
Okay.
Hello, sir. Yeah, unmute yourself.
Oh, okay. Now, can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, please.
Yes.
Yeah, he is my classmate. He is working in LIC. He is my classmate. Tell me, Kathy.
Thank you. Okay. Sir, I feel I am always, most of the time, I am dependent on others. My wife, my parents, and my friends, and my relatives. Mm. That's the way I have grown up. Always depending on others. Okay. But my wife has not been like that. Has not grown like that. At some instances, we feel there is some restlessness between me.
Okay, between yourself and your wife.
Between me. Yes, I am thinking like that.
Within yourself.
She is not depending on me like that.
Okay. You said very clearly that you have been developed like that. You are depending on so many people. Right. Okay. You just question yourself whether you are highly capable of making your wife dependent. I think she is playing the beautiful role and that's why you are enjoying her life.
Yeah,
okay?
Definitely.
She is taking the lead role. Okay?
Yeah,
appreciate her and be happy for that.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Sir, we have a question.
Okay, Kathy.
Yeah, thank you.
Please.
Again, sir. We have a question from Vijay Kumar, sir.
Please.
Vijay Kumar, sir.
Hello. Yes. Yeah, please, doctor. Hello.
Sir, kya karunga?
Hello.
Sir, please. Sir, if both man and woman are working, is it like what I feel is like financial? இது வந்து எப்படி மேனேஜ் பண்றது ஃபினான்ஷியல் மேனேஜ்மென்ட் வந்து ஐ திங்க் லைக் இட் ஷட் 100 ஆர் இட் ஷட் பீ ட்ரான்ஸ்பரன்ட் அந்த மாதிரி கேக்குறேன்
இட் ஷட் பீ ட்ரான்ஸ்பரன்ட் தட்ஸ் தி ரைட் வே இட் ஷட் பீ ட்ரான்ஸ்பரன்ட் only then you will have the mutual trust
see because
normally try to get the point normally women they won't waste the money okay men then normally they will divert the money for so many activities women it depends on again the particular woman whether they are spending it for a jewel or a silk service except that normally women will not waste the money they are the basics basically they are the saving personalities even if you give 100 rupees for expenses they are capable of retaining 10 rupees or 20 rupees from that 100 rupees that's a basic woman attitude right so it should be transparent that's a healthy trait And moreover, if your woman is highly capable of handling the money, better you can leave the money with her, let her handle it. But one of the safest zone of the woman is they are never ready to handle all the money related issues in the home. Okay? There will be, I have seen with many clients, the working woman, they are ready to handle the household activities and they are ready to spend for that. And they're ready to keep the account for that. But for the other related activities and loan, debits and all, they're not ready to take the headache. So in which case, men, you can look after the things. It depends purely on the understanding between you two people.
Yeah, there are few people. My question is, there are few people where the woman says, I'll earn my money, I'll keep it for myself, and you'll have to... then for whatever the family expenses are
that means you never created the trust with your woman that's their problem the male member's problem see if the woman feels that I am in the safe hands she will not do like that so there is a mistrust about the male member in the family that's why woman is doing that
the problem arises as soon as the marriage is marriage has happened
Okay.
It's not my personal question, sir.
No, I'm not thinking that it's your personal question.
Yeah.
I'm not taking it that way.
That's not a problem. See, right from the beginning of the marriage itself, this problem is arising. That is why I asked this question.
Yeah, that's what I'm telling you. Your marital relationship has not been properly bonded. Okay? The trust has been not created between those two people. It's totally the issue related with the trust, mutual trust.
Okay.
Okay. For example, if the woman the woman normally expect a protection and care from the men. I have mentioned about Balakumaran's this thing. So protection from the men. So the woman may feel that she is insecure. Okay, that might be the reason she is looking for the financial security. And of course, in a way, she is. If you ask me, in a way, she is right. So it's your bound duty. Being the male member, it is your bound duty to provide every comfort to your own woman. Okay, let her keep the money. She will not throw the money in the road.
Mama,
sir, thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
My answer was even more like a firework than the real session. I request Suresh Kumar sir to give word of thanks before we run out of the time.
Yes, sir. Actually, Suresh, is it your kid voice? Your son's voice, is it?
Yes.
He's with you?
Yeah. He's taking lessons.
Okay.